Dear students, we will be covering in this module the major data sources which captures the various demographic, socio-economic and health related issues, especially in the country like India. Their major learning objectives are to focus on sample registration system in India, basic structure of the sample registration system, sample design and analytical studies on sample registration. The government of India in the late 1960s initiated the sample registration system that is based on a dual recording system. In the sample registration system, there is a continuous enumeration of births and deaths in a sample of villages or urban blocks by a resident part-time enumerator, and then an independent six-monthly retrospective survey by a full-time supervisor. The data thus obtained through these two sources are matched. The unmatched and partially matched events are re-verified in the field to get the correct number of events. At present, the sample registration system, usually known as SRS, provides reliable annual data on fertility and mortality at the state and national levels for rural and urban areas separately. SRS estimates or vital rates are being extensively used for policy making and planning purposes. In the absence of reliable CRS data, the SRS has been the authoritative source if vital rates as a national and state levels. Registrar General of India also uses SRS data for obtaining abridged life table at national and state levels. However, it is not a substitute for CRS. It does provide estimate at lower level of aggregation. Even at the state level, questions are being raised about the sample size of the SRS to provide reliable estimates. The sampling units in SRS are revised at an interval of 10 years as cited by Registrar General of India 2011. The statistics available from SRS focusing on various issues related to the demographic issues like population distribution, fertility, mortality, access to medical care with respect to various statistics and its availability and location are discussed. The revision of SRS sampling frame is undertaken every 10 years based on the results of latest census. While changing the sample, modifications in the sampling design to wider representation of population, overcoming the limitations in the existing scheme, meeting the additional requirements, etc., are taken into account. The first replacement was carried out way back in 1977 to 78, and the last one being in 2014. Whereas the replacement of samples in earlier years was undertaken in phases spread over 2 to 3 years, the last two replacements in 2004 and 2014 were done in one go within a year. The following table provides the sample size in different replacement periods. Number of sample units at a different replacement periods with reference to periods like 1969 to 70, 77 to 78, 83 to 85, 93 to 95, 2004 and 2014 with respect to the residential locations like rural or urban and total as a whole. The earlier sample was based on the reliability of birth rate at the state level, whereas the 2004 and 2014 samples are estimated using IMR reliability. In 1964, when the scheme was introduced, the selection of pilot villages was made purposefully in order to present typical conditions in the state. Subsequently, in 1966, when experience of running a pilot survey in 7 states was available, a subsample of 20 villages out of the total sample was taken up. Pilot surveys in urban areas were also conducted in a few states since 1964 for formulating the methodology for the collection of data. The full-scale survey was launched in urban areas of most of the states in 1967 to 68. The number of sample units then ranged from 40 to 100 in states. In the union territories, the sample size is small. At present, the SRS is being implemented in all the states and the union territories on a full scale, both in rural and urban areas. Let's discuss about the basic structure of the sample registration system. The objective, the major purpose of sample registration system is to provide reliable annual estimates of vital rates separately for rural and urban areas. It also provides other indicators of fertility and mortality like age-specific fertility rates, mortality rates, etc. What about the structure of the system? The sample registration system is a miniature enumeration system of a large-scale demographic sample survey which is being conducted in a random sample of villages and urban blocks and is based on the idea that with an adequate machinery for recording of births and deaths as they occur and with proper supervision at all levels, it is possible to obtain reliable estimates of vital rates at the state and the national levels. The system combines the advantages of both continuous or longitudinal enumeration and survey procedures. The field investigation under sample registration system essentially consists of continuous enumeration of births and deaths by a part-time enumerator, preferably a local person, and an independent survey every 6 months by a full-time field functionary called the department official. The data thus obtained through these two methods are matched. The unmatched or partially matched events are re-verified in the field to obtain an unduplicated count of correct births and deaths in each sample unit. To start with, a baseline survey of the sample units is also carried out. Thereafter, the baseline population is updated at the time of half-yearly surveys for working out various vital rates. The essential features of the system are therefore: A. Baseline survey of sample units to obtain usual resident population of the sample areas. B. Continuous or longitudinal enumeration of vital events pertaining to usual residence population by the enumerator. C. An independent half-yearly survey of births and deaths by the departmental official updating the national map, house list, household schedules and list of pregnant women. D. Matching of events enumerated as part of continuous enumeration and listed during the course of half-yearly surveys. And E. Field re-verification of unmatched or partially matched events. F. Finalization and dispatch of half-yearly results to ORG. Let's discuss about baseline survey. The baseline survey is carried out prior to the start of continuous enumeration. This involves preparation of a national map of the area to be surveyed, house numbering and house listing, and filling in of a household schedule. Wherever a sound system of house numbering exists, the same is adopted. Otherwise, the house numbering is done by the enumerator or supervisor with the help of chalk and tar, etc., auspicious place near the entrance of the house. The supervisor prepares a national map with the help of the enumerator showing important landmarks and location of the houses covered by the sample unit. He then prepares a list of houses or households covered by the sample in the house list, that is form 1, and fills in the household schedule form 2, wherein he records the residential status and the demographic particulars of each individual residing in the household, namely name, sex, age, marital status and relation to head of household, etc. The inmates of public institutions like hotels, inns, schools and hospitals are excluded, but households are living permanently within the compound of such institutions are covered. A list of pregnant women, that is in form 3, is also prepared at the time of the baseline survey. The next focus is on continuous enumeration. The enumerator maintains a birth record, that is in form 4, and a death record, form 5, in respect of this area. The enumerator is expected to record all births and deaths occurring within the sample unit, as well as those of the usual residents occurring outside the sample unit. The events to visitors occurring within the sample unit are also listed, but these are not taken into account while calculating various rates. Thus, the events to be enumerated by the enumerator are those pertaining to 1. Usual residents inside the sample unit, 2. Usual residents outside of the sample unit, 3. In-migrants present, 4. In-migrants absent, 5. Visitors inside the sample unit. For ensuring complete netting, the enumerator uses different means to get information of the occurrence of vital events in the sample unit. He takes the help of the village priest, barber, village headman, midwife and such other functionaries and contacts these informants at frequent intervals and collect information about the occurrence of births and deaths. On being informed about the occurrence of an event, he visits the concerned household and records the prescribed particulars. He also keeps in touch with other socially important persons and visits local or nearby hospitals, nursing homes, cremation or burial grounds at frequent intervals to keep himself informed about the occurrence of events. He is required to maintain a list of pregnant women, that is form 3, which helps him in the netting of all the births. Despite all these efforts, the enumerator may fail to have information about some of the events. Therefore, he is required to visit all the households once in each quarter in rural areas and once in a month in urban areas, so as to ensure that all the events have been recorded. Also, we should discuss about half-yearly surveys. The half-yearly survey is carried out independently in each sample unit by a full-time supervisor. The supervisor belonging to the statistical cadre of the census directorates, either a computer or a statistical assistant or any suitable official, visits households in the sample unit and records the particulars of births and deaths in forms 9 and 10 respectively pertaining to usual residents and to visitors, that is only those occurring within the sample unit which had occurred during the half yearly period, usually January-June or July-December under reference. Simultaneously, he updates the house list, the household schedule and list of pregnant women by making suitable entries. In carrying out this survey, he does not have access to the births and death records of the enumerator, which are withdrawn from the field before the supervisor is deputed for the half-yearly survey. An overlapping reference period of 1 year is also adopted in the survey in order to net the events which might have been missed in the previous half-yearly survey. We need to discuss about issue related to matching. On completion of the half-yearly survey, the forms 9 and 10 filled in by the supervisors are compared with the forms 4 and 5 filled in by the enumerators. This is done either at the state or district headquarters or at regional centers. Each entry in the numerators and supervisors record is matched item by item, and events are classified as fully matched, partially matched, and unmatched. The items generally considered for matching are the location of the household, that is, name of the head of household and house number, the name of the mother for birth, and the name of the deceased and cause of death in case of death, residential status, sex, and month of occurrence. Re-verification of unmatched events. After matching, partially matched or unmatched events noticed in the two sets of records are referred back to the field to find out the correct position. There, verification is done either by a third person or jointly by the departmental official and the enumerator, depending upon the availability of staff. However, matching and joint re-verification of partially matched or unmatched events by enumerator and departmental official is to be avoided to minimize chances of their collusion in making out corrections in their records without the knowledge of state authorities. Details of additional events detecting during the course of half-yearly survey and re-verification are also collected in the appropriate form. At the end of 6 monthly period, the results of matching and re-verification and population by age and sex for each unit are sent in the prescribed forms by the state headquarters to the Office of the Registrar General, India, for tabulation and analysis. Let's discuss about time schedule of various SRS operations for the conduct of half-yearly surveys. Time schedule of various SRS options for the conduct of half-yearly surveys are divided in different operations, like in field work, matching, re-verification, and finalization of results. The table depicts the expected definitions and also expected time periods. In other words, all the basis operations for one half-yearly surveys of sample registration system are expected to be completed in 5 months' time. Let's focus about sample design. In that, sampling units is the first focus. A village is the sampling unit in every stratum, which includes villages with population under 1,500 in the last census. The uninhabited villages are excluded from the frame. In villages having population of 1,501 and above in last census, the sampling unit will be a segment of the village such that the villages were segmented into two or more segments of equal size. Let's discuss about selection procedure. Sample selection is to be carried out by the Office of the Registrar General, India. The list of sampling units in rural and urban areas of all states, union territories will be supplied by Office of the Registrar General of India. The sample unit will be selected on the basis of list of villages or blocks based on the primary census abstract of latest census. The sample design adopted for SRS is a unistage stratified simple random sample without replacement. In rural areas, each district within a state has been divided into two strata, namely strata 1, villages with population less than or equal to 1,500, and strata 2 villages with population more than 1500. In order to cover the village by one part-time enumerator, villages belonging to the second strata, that is having population of more than 1500, were segmented into two or more segments of equal size. In the case of urban areas, stratification has been done on the basis of size class of the towns or cities. The towns or cities were grouped into five classes, namely towns with a population below 20,000, B, towns with a population of 20,000 and more but less than 50,000, C, towns with a population of 50,000 and more but less than 1 lakh, and D, towns with a population of 1 lakh and more but less than 5 lakhs, and E, cities with a population of 5 lakh and more but less than 10 lakhs, and F, each city with a population of 10 lakhs or more, treated as a separate stratum. The sampling unit in urban areas is a census enumeration block. Let's discuss about construction of sampling frames. The last census village directory for each district is the base from which the frame is to be constructed by Office of the Registrar General India. All inhabited villages from the taluks or tehsils will be grouped into two size groups as follows. 1. Villages with a population less than 1500. 2. Villages with population more than 1500. The following information are published annually with a time lag of about 2 years for major states, separately for rural and urban areas. 1. Age sex distribution. 2. Marital status. 3. Fertility indicators like A, age specific fertility rate, B, age specific marital fertility rate, C, CBR, GFR and GMFR, and D, total fertility rate and total marital fertility rate, E, birth order distribution and birth interval data. 4. Mortality indicators like A, crude death rate, B, age specific death rate, C, infant mortality rate, that is neonatal, postneonatal, perinatal and stillbirths. D, sample registration system based life tables are separately published. SRS also publishes the distribution of live births by type of medical attention received by the mother at the time of delivery. This is an annual publication with a 2 to 3 year time lag. However, summary indicators are made available within a shorter time lag. The table depicts the various sources like SRS, Census, CRS, NFHS with its respective periodicity, estimated parameters, small area estimates and usability. The completeness of registration of vital events by this SRS is an important issue. The various operations of continuous enumeration and half-yearly surveys are depicted in the flow chart, which is very important for us to understand when we are discussing about sample registration system. The list of analytical studies on sample registration is also an important issue. For example, A, efficiency of the sample design. Sample size, that is number of sample units for rural and urban areas for each state and union territory, which would yield vital rates with a fairly reliable degree of accuracy. When the SRS was planned, the idea in having a sample size of 150 rural units was to secure the estimates of birth rate with 1% permissible error and of death rate with 2% permissible error. Is this objective being fulfilled? 2. Optimum size of sample unit, either in rural and urban areas, keeping in view the workload, efficiency of enumerator and departmental official, etc., data could be analyzed to assess the performance of enumerators and department officials in terms of percentage of correct events covered by them in sample units of different population sizes. In other words, we may examine whether bigger units are poorer in performance. 3. efficiency of stratification, that is, how far the stratification of villages within a natural division by population size of villages has resulted in increasing the efficiency of the estimates. 4. Relative efficiency of A. completely covering the primary sampling units and B. subsampling the primary sampling units. 5. Study on the existence, nature, magnitude and method of control of conditioning effect in half-yearly surveys, as also in repeating sample registration in the same set of villages. This question is linked up with rotation of sample. Let's discuss about performance of enumerators and department officials. 1. Comparative performance of enumerators by type, namely teachers, health staff, etc. 2. Study of the increase or decrease in the efficiency of the same enumerator over a period of time and reasons thereof. 3. Comparative efficiency of part-time and full-time enumerators in urban areas in terms of percentage of correct events netted or missed by each. 4. Role of informants in the rural areas vis-a-vis the percentage of births or deaths reported by different informants and those netted by enumerator through his or her own efforts. 5. Time lag in the occurrence of the events and their enumeration by the enumerator. 6. Comparison of events netted under sample registration with those under statutory registration. 7. Comparative performance of departmental officials by type of departmental officials. 8. Comparative efficiency of part-time and full-time departmental officials in rural and urban areas in terms of percentage of correct events netted and missed. 9. Extent of independence between the work of enumerators and departmental officials, that is to study A. whether the work of department officials is really independent from that of enumerators. B. Is the performance of departmental officials better than the enumerators? 10. Type of events which are missed by the enumerators and by the departmental officials and reasons therefore, including births which are followed immediately by deaths. 11. Number and percentage of units where half-yearly surveys are not included, conducted at all at the end of that half year and are tagged with the next half-yearly survey. 12. Time lag in A. receipt of monthly reports. B. Conduct of half-yearly surveys. C. Receipt of half-yearly results. And D. Finalization of Form 10 after matching and re-verification. 13. Results of intensive enquiries. 14. Number and percentage of births reported in list of pregnant women to total births. Let's discuss about C. matching. Best and workable criterion for matching, that is, what minimum items should be taken into consideration for matching of enumerators and department officials' records of vital events. How far the department officials should also be made to collect the same items of information about each vital event as those collected by the enumerators, that is, should the forms be identical? 3. Experience with regard to the overlapping period, that is, of covering a reference period of last 1 year at the time of each half-yearly surveys, keeping in view also the difficulties of matching events of first half-year. Closely linked up with this is the relationship between accuracy of vital data and length of reference period. Let's talk about the issue related to various vital rates. Differential in vital rates by religion, differential in birth rates by the education standard of the mother, differential in vital rates in areas of known intensive and non-intensive family planning inputs wherever possible, extent of institutional and domiciliary births or deaths, number of births or deaths occurring within and outside the sample units, plurality of births, that is number of multiple births, seasonality in birth and death rates, number of stillbirths per 1000 live births, birth rates by age of mother and duration of marriage, birth intervals, birth order, age-specific birth and death rates and their comparison with other sources, number of male or female births and deaths. Let's focus on infant mortality aspects. Infant mortality rates and their comparison with other sources, prenatal or neonatal mortality rates and their comparison with other sources, F, population, that is comparison of age and sex distribution of population covered by sample registration with alternate sources, 2, distribution of households at each half yearly sources by number of usual residents, G, migration, that is extent of out migration of households or individuals between the two half yearly surveys based on data in household schedule, that is in form 2, extent of in migration of households or individuals between the two half yearly surveys, 3, extent of changes between the two half yearly surveys in A, number of houses, B, number of households, and C, number of single member households. H is focusing on miscellaneous issues like 1, comparison of growth rates based on sample registration with the census growth rates, 2, age at effective marriage of current mothers, and these are the issues. So, in this way, this module has clearly focused on various issues related to sample registration system, the various ways of how the system has been placed, its basic structure, the sample design, and various analytical studies on sample registration have been covered in this module.